Good morning, students. Welcome back to your computer lecture. In previous topics, we covered introduction about computers. We understood the generations, first, second, third, fourth, fifth generations. Then we looked at various parts of computer, the hardware components, the primary devices, the keyboard. Then we understood the processing, how the working of a computer is. Today, in this lecture, we will look at some software side. I request all the students to kindly be ready with their workbook and a pencil and open page number 5 or page number 25, chapter number 5. Let's begin. Chapter 5, Educational Games and Learning by Means of Computer. Educational Games in Windows. Now, as we know, computers are not only used for calculations, but for many other uses are there. One usage is entertainment, which includes few games. These are termed under educational games. Let's see what are those examples. Minesweeper, solitaire. So the first educational game is Minesweeper. Let's read. For playing this game, using the following steps, first load it in a computer. Choose this game by clicking the start menu and by the game's accessory under the heading Programs Accessories. Now you will see the Minesweeper's window on the screen. On the main menu bar of this window, there is the option of Game. When you click on it, you will see the following menu. So it talks about how do we start. How do we begin with this game, Minesweeper? We click on Start, Programs, and there is Accessories, and from there we select Games. Under Games, we have Minesweeper. The picture below shows how this game looks like. If you see the second picture, once you click on the game option, it shows you the following options like beginner, intermediate, expert. To quickly show you, this is how a Minesweeper game looks like. Take a look. Let's try to understand. This game can be played in three levels of beginner, intermediate, expert. For beginners, the window comes smaller, while for experts, the window is bigger. It's more or like the game of Sudoku. I'm sure in the newspaper, if we may have not seen Minesweeper game, we can try relating it to Sudoku, the game of Sudoku, which mostly appears in newspapers, or we may have played this online as well, or on the applications. There are three types of level: beginner, intermediate, expert. And depending upon the level, the size of the window is decided. Like it's small for beginners and big for experts. What is this game all about? Let's see. In this window, there are small squares. While playing the game, we have to click in these squares by the mouse. If there is mine under the square, then the game is stopped. Otherwise, a number is seen as shown in the figure. See below. This number indicates that those much mines are under the other squares, which are around that square. Accordingly, with due thought, the square is to be clicked further. If you are sure that there are mines on those squares, then the right button of the mouse should be clicked on that square. There a flag is seen. Thinking in this way, next square is to be clicked. For more information, use help key. So this is nothing but this paragraph explains the instructions or the directions how the game is played. So as you see in this picture, there are squares, unseen squares, and there are some folded squares, fold and unfold squares. With the help of the mouse, you unfold the squares and try to score as much as points. So as the rule says, if you click on the mine is a black dot with spokes or spines, you can see. There's 1, 2, 3, and those black circle with spikes or spokes, that's a mine. So if you click on the, if you try to unfold these blocks, you click on one of these blocks, and if it turns out to be a mine, the game is stopped, it's over. Otherwise, a number is seen, like it can be 3, 2, 1, which indicates those many mines around the blocks. You can try to do a right click and see if the box that you're trying to click, or the square that you're trying to click, if it's a mine. You can try to right click on that particular block and see if there is any red flag that comes. And then it says, for more help, press the help key. Next to the game option, there's a help. Once you click on help, more additional information or additional assistance will be provided by the computer, which is as per the game. So this is Minesweeper. Let's see the second game, Solitaire. In the window of this game, there is a set of cards at the extreme left hand with the pictures on the upper side, which can be seen. After some blank space, there are four empty squares to the right side. Down to it, there is open space, and under it, the cards are set. In these set cards, if there is an ace, it should be carried to one square out of four ones. In the extreme upper right corner, by double clicking it, by which it will enter in one of the squares. In this way, the four aces should be taken in four squares. By clicking the set of the cards at the upper corner, one or three cards can be taken out at a time. By choosing the cards from this set, they can be laid on the downward cards. Example, on the card of club, we'll come to the example later. Solitaire is another game which relates with cards, playing cards. We all must have seen the playing cards. Let's take a look at the picture. Oh, this picture talks about. As you can see in this picture, there are few cards laid, folded and unfolded. So this is, you have to arrange the cards in sequence, starting from A, which is known as Ace, then King, Queen, जिस तरह से हम हिंदी में कहते हैं इक्का बादशाह रानी, राइट. सो इन इंग्लिश टर्मिनोलॉजी दैट ए इज नोन एज एस, फॉलोड बाई किंग, क्वीन, जैक, देन द नंबर्स. Let's take a look at the example. Example. On the card of club 10th, red colored, heart or diamond, 9th card is to be laid sequentially. On the red 9th card, the 8th card of black color, club or spade, is to be placed. In the upper right corner squares, the cards are to be set sequentially color wise. That is, on the heart ace, all the remaining 12 card of heart. On the diamond ace, all the remaining cards sequentially of diamond only. So the game rule is to place all the cards sequentially, followed by ace, king. Or it can go as ace, 2, 3, 4, 5, depending on the rules. This game is to be played in the shortest time. In the window of this game, at the right hand bottom, the score and the time are indicated. Games should be played by keeping an eye on these two. When all the cards go in their respective places, the game is over. Alright. The idea behind the game, that it should be played in the shortest time. The fastest, you finish the game. Let's take a look at this colorful picture. This is how a game of solitaire will look like. So as you see, the top right corner, you have A of spade. The ones which are in black, it looks like inverted heart or like a leaf, are known as spades. Then we have diamonds. Then we have hearts and flowers. These are cards, this has to be arranged. As the example says, on the card of club 10th, red colored heart or diamond, 9th is to be laid sequentially. So the numbers has to be there, but it has to be of opposite colors. One of the interesting games. The idea behind this game is to develop the thinking power and to act fast. So these are the two games, Solitaire and Minesweeper, as educational games. This could be found in older operating systems. Newer operating systems like Windows 10 may have different options, different games. Once our schools starts business as usual, when we start conducting practicals, we can certainly try to take a look or do a hands-on practice on these two games, Minesweeper and Solitaire, and see how these games help us. In our further lecture, we will look at the other topics. It's learning by means of computer. So the other topic is learning by the help of computer. Though we humans have designed these computers, we certainly have many things to learn from computers as well. There's deep knowledge about computers. We need to explore it. Even computers have, the features of computers have expanded or so enhanced that the more you try to get know about it, the less it feels. We'll still try to learn as per the syllabus and try to cover as much as possible in the syllabus. The first topic says Introduction to Windows, which is on page number 27. Let us read. Windows is a multitasking operating system. Multitasking means to do many jobs at a time. By using the Windows operating system, we can make use of more than one program at a time. So also, by opening two programs at a time, can exchange the information in it. Example, the table in Excel can be used in Word. So in the introduction part, what it says, Windows is a multitasking operating system. What multitasking means? The word multi itself means multiple things. And tasking means various tasks that can be performed at the same time. So multitasking means to do or to perform various tasks or jobs at the same time, simultaneously. So Windows as a feature or as an operating system has this feature of multitasking. And even if one or two applications are open, they can still share each other's information. The example given here is the table in Excel can be used in Word. One example that we can try to relate with this feature is a tiffin box during school hours and during recess. We all carry our own tiffins. We all have our own feature, right? Microsoft Excel, Microsoft Word, they all have their own features. You all carry your own tiffins. Still, we share with each other. We share some of our share of food with our friends, and some we taste from their tiffin. Right. Keeping our own features intact. We eat our dabba, right? This is multitasking. You're sharing two tiffins at the same time. Let's read below. Windows is the GUI, that is graphical user interface based operating system. GUI means the information is shown on the monitor by pictures. Because of this, it is very easy to remember. This is one of the reasons for the Windows system being popular. Windows is GUI, that's graphical user interface. We'll break the word graphical user interface to understand in this way. The center word user means for us. Interface is like a platform. And graphical, which includes pictures, images, videos in the form of graph, flowcharts, pie, all pictorial formats. So graphical user interface. So it's designed in the form of, the user interface is designed in the form of pictures and graphs and images, so that it becomes easier for us to remember these things. And that is why Windows is most popular. If you may have seen Apple or Mac operating system, it is one of the known operating system. However, the graphical user interface is not that user-friendly. User-friendly, if I mean to say, you have to remember each and every click. But in Windows, it's in the form of pictures that helps you to remember in a better way. This is the Windows part. In a further lecture, we'll try to understand more about Windows and its other features and options. Like the title bar, menu bar, status bar. We will look at these options and cover these topics as well.